operasi.
Let me introduce myself. My name is Santi. I'm a half of Indigirilas. So Indigirilas is actually two. And the other half is Miko. He's somewhere. So yeah. We are started in 1999. As a graphic design bureau, as a collective. So in that time, one of our clients was Yayasan Seni Cemeti, and now known as IFA. We was design their bulletin and some of book, and through this process, we little by little learn about art and get into Yogyakarta art scene. And then in 2002, we and some other friends initiate to publish a magazine named Outmax. It contains about everyday life, art, music, film, and anything about popular culture. And in the same year, there was a tour exhibition of poster art from France called Science, held on Cemeti Art House. And in the process, they invite some of Jogja designers to exhibit the artwork. And we are very glad can be the part of it. And it will become Indigirilas' first group exhibition. And since that, we are active to participate some art exhibition, and we decided to keep 10% of our earning as a graphic designer to produce artworks. And to reach a wider audience, we started to upload the images of our artwork via social media called Flickr. There's no Instagram before, so we use Flickr. And after that, we get into urban art community. And then there was a lot of invitation from abroad come to exhibit our artworks. 2002, we participate in 7 exhibition. So we must working hard to earn some money to produce artworks. Otherwise, we easily to broke. And 2008, Indigirilas does the first solo show in Biasa Art Space, curated by Sujita Tanto. The title was Folklore. Yeah. Here's the artworks. And in 2008, Indigirilas also participated to 13 group exhibition in same year. So in this year, we are started to thinking about becoming a full-time artist. And this decision is based on our thought that in art, there is no revision like design, because yeah, designers sometimes is work for other people. So yeah, then in art also there's a freedom to do anything, include doing a mistake. And sometimes a mistake can become a key to another creativity journey. And second thing, we spend most of our time in front of computer, and our mind becoming attached to comment, just like easily to copy, paste, undo, delete, and then we need balancing our analog and digital life, something like that. After that, we more focus on preparing some exhibition, just like Animemic Biennale at Muka Taipei in 2008. And then in 2010, we do our second solo show at VWFA Singapore, titled Happy Victim. Happy Victim is self-reflection. Because we are happy to become a victim of consumerism, something like that. Yeah. And then in the same year, we do another exhibition, solo exhibition called In the what? In the who? Who's the advert? And in the same year also, we make our merchandise, clothing line, is also called Happy Victim. And we go into artist residency program in Den Haag, supported by Hayden and Cosmopolis Den Haag and also Cemeti Artists. And 2011, we are participated in the fourth Guangzhou Triennale in China. And then Future Pass from Asia to the World is a collateral event of Venice Biennale. Do some set specific space in Gilman Barat. And then we participate in Marcel Duchamp in Southeast Asia. Here's one of our latest artworks. So I want to share our creative process. Let me explain a little bit. We are still influenced by designer methods. So in the beginning, we do brainstorming first to decide what kind of idea, story, or concept behind the artworks, and then make a sketch, coloring still in the computer for the color grading, and decided what material we use, what kind of finishing, lighting simulation, etc. And after that, we battling each other like a street artist. So our ideas also come from everyday life, from reading news, book, tweet, social media, listening a song, traveling, see exhibition, mingling or associated with friends, families, or even person that has totally different interests with us. So we also try to digging our roots, our tradition, that have their own wisdom and bringing into our today's life. And strategies. We have planning that brother links, one of them that making our own place that a small scale artist residency. It's kind of more like more casual. So maybe there's some artists that too shy to show off or to talk to many people. So just stay at my house and yeah, meet some person, do like a secretly residency or something like that. Okay. And make an event or art exhibition, attending important exhibition abroad, make link outside art, making publicity, improve our website, social media, making a book and magazine. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Santi. In the US, I have to ask the organizer. I think we need a little bit of break. Yeah. Hopefully, okay. So.